All right. Well, good day, everyone. John McNichol here, and welcome to Trading with Technical Indicators. So a technical analysis, price and volume. Is volume important? Is it overrated? Or maybe is balanced in between? We're going to discuss on balance volume as a technical indicator that may be an aid to whether potentially confirm price action, or possibly go with the adage that volume precedes price. That'll be our topic here today on Trading with Technical Indicators. So let's go ahead and get into it. I'm joined by my good friend, Mr. Lee Bull on the chat. I'd like to appreciate those that are live with us today, such as Barack, Kathy, Michael, Tom, and everyone else, and those of you that are listening to the archive session as well. Keep in mind, the information here is for general information purposes only and should not be considered an individualized recommendation or endorsement of any particular security, chart pattern, or investment strategy. Keep in mind that Schwab does not recommend the use of technical analysis as the sole means of investment research. The paper money software application is for educational purposes only, and successful virtual trading during one time period does not guarantee success of actual funds or successful investment of actual funds during a later time period, as market conditions change constantly. Past performance, not a guarantee of future results or success. And for the sake of simplicity, the examples in this presentation do not take in consideration commission or other transaction fees, tax consequent considerations, things like that. Also, investing involves risks, including the loss of principal. So for those of you that have been joining me over the last couple of weeks, we've been going over some of the key components of technical analysis and applying indicators to help support those principles, such as trend, support, and resistance. Now we're going to talk a little more about volume. So as we discuss these principles, we're going to utilize on balance volume as our main example for today, not only show you the indicator, but show you some productivity tools such as ThinkScript, where we can create a quote column that may be a representation of what on balance volume is doing. I'll also share with you a sample scan to look for some potential volume triggers on stocks that may be changing, whether possibly to the upside or to the downside. And as always, we'll go ahead and utilize examples on the charts too. So here we go. Remember, technical analysis, not the sole tool when it comes to analysis here. Fundamental analysis can have an important part, particularly for longer duration trades, trend trades. And keep in mind, around those earnings events where there can be more volatility, those fundamentals can change and be reflective on the charts as well. Now, notice as we look at technical analysis, we're utilizing tools to analyze price and also potentially volume. Looking at previous patterns in the market, anticipating those patterns may go ahead and repeat themselves. Now, we've gone over this each and every week, the principles on technical analysis. A lot of the focus is on price, trends, support and resistance, and averages there. Notice volume is not as prominent in this discussion, with the exception of the point on number five, that volume must confirm the trend. Volume should increase in the direction of the trend. Now, there are several different volume indicators that one can utilize. We're going to focus on the on-balance volume, and particularly the on-balance modified indicator for our discussion here today. And as we go forward here, now some of the indicators that we've been discussing over the last few weeks, utilizing moving averages. Last week, we talked about utilizing a combination of moving averages, utilizing some Fibonacci series in the discussion. You'll see those same indicators on here today. This is what's going to help us analyze price trends over different periods of time. Also, you'll notice on the chart, we have the MACD, a momentum indicator to highlight if price is moving. You know, is there momentum behind it, or if momentum slowing down? Stronger trends, momentum should increase. During points of consolidation, think of price patterns such as rectangles and triangles, that momentum may slow down as those price formations are formed and traders looking for those breakouts, typically confirmed by volume, to demonstrate that price may be resuming its trend, or if it's going the opposite way, reversing its previous trend. Now, I want to make a mental note, or have you make a mental note. We will not be broadcasting next week during Christmas week. So it's a great opportunity for you to go back, look at my playlist for this class, as well as flag trading on Tuesdays. We'll have links to the playlist in the description, but we will start off the new year talking about relative strength and kind of two components. One, relative strength, how strong is a stock compared to itself? We'll also be talking about relative strength, comparing an instrument against a benchmark, particularly the S&P 500. So hopefully you have a New Year's resolution to continue your education with us, as we'll talk about that in the new year. Now, here's our topic, on balance volume. On balance volume is an indicator that uses cumulative buying and selling pressure to indicate a likely change in price. Operative word is likely. There could be instances of lower volume environments where whether it's institutions can be a push in price action, and it may not necessarily be on heavy volume. So we're going to go ahead and take a look at this indicator and apply it on balance with some of the other tools that we have on the thinkorswim platform. And as you look at this illustrative example here, as with many indicators, volume may confirm what price action is doing, or it may deny or diverge with what price action is doing. And actually on this slide example is an example of a divergence. Now in the past, we've talked about divergences on the MACD. On balance volume, as well as many other indicators, can demonstrate divergences. In this case, a negative divergence where price is making a higher high. However, over the same period of time, notice that the on balance volume, this volume indicator, was making lower highs. Now, this supports one of the technical sayings as far as volume, that volume precedes price. And this is potentially an example of that. As prices make those highs, volume may start tapering off, that demand may start tapering off, that may translate into selling at some point. And likewise, in the case of on balance volume, that would fall and drop, showing that that volume may be dropping off. Now, keep in mind, price is a very important indicator and typically one that may trigger entries and exits. One would look for price to confirm that volume as well. All right, now we'll keep an eye if you do have any questions here, but let's go ahead and go right to the thinkorswim platform. And we'll bring up on balance volume. We're going to look at it a few different ways. By the way, S&P pushing higher today. I believe all the major market indices have been making some moves, coming close or making some 52-week highs, as well as taking out some close to all-time highs for some of the indices. Looks like the Russell's kind of slowed up a little bit there compared to what the S&P and the NASDAQ was doing. We'll bring up the Dow real quick. It's like the Dow's pushing and in some highs, backing off the high a little bit intraday here. So I'm going to go ahead and bring up Apple as an example here. And if you're looking at the chart, we have a combination of those moving averages that we discussed last week. We can see in this example that Apple is a trending stock. Prices above those averages, making higher highs and higher lows. We actually have a little bit of a flagging pattern. This may be a point of a discussion tomorrow in our trading flags class. Making a sharp move, we're seeing price pull back over the last couple of days. Now, a little interesting there, notice that there's a little spike in volume. I have just some volume displayed on the chart here, and you can see the volume bars for each and every day. This is actually volume average. It's an indicator you can go ahead and add by simply going to the flask on the chart to edit your studies, and you can go ahead and look for volume average. What that'll actually do is it will plot, right? Yeah, volume average right here. By the way, you can always click on these little question marks when you're looking at your indicators to learn a little more about them. And here in this case, volume average, that's going to plot a moving average for that volume. Also, the colors of those bars would represent, if it's an up day, it allot it to more bullish volume. If it's a down day, it allot it more towards bearish volume. And that's kind of tied into on balance volume. Whereas if I go ahead and look at this chart overall, we can go ahead and let me just bring it out here a little bit. As we look at this chart overall, you can see these volume bars. Some of those volume bars may be a bit taller, demonstrate more heavier volume. Other bars, smaller, demonstrating lesser volume there. And you can see how that may fluctuate day to day. So what does on balance volume come into? Well, I'm going to go ahead back to the flask there. And we'll type in on balance. And there's two we're going to discuss today. First is on balance volume. The second one, which will be more applying here today, is the on balance volume modified. Now, if I go ahead and click on the on balance volume description, the on balance volume is keeping a running total of volume that may be going into or out of the security. When the security closes higher than the previous close, all the day's volume is considered to be an up day. Okay. So it's not fully scientific. It's not necessarily calculating all the buys and sell orders. If it's a higher close, it's considered to be good volume. If it's a lower close, it's considered to be more negative volume. And what it does is it calculates those over a period of time. And the idea being a rising OBV for our discussion is defined as potentially a sign of smart money institutions. Again, no classification of that, but going off the assumptions, if there's more volume, more participation into that security going to the upside. Whereas if the on-balance volume is falling, then that may demonstrate a little more negative here. And it's also highlighting the divergences that we talked about in the slide, that if the price movement precedes the on-balance volume movement, it's called a non-confirmation. Non-confirmations tend to occur at bull market tops or at bear market bottoms here. And again, these divergences can occur at any time, but typically we may see these divergences occur at tops or bottoms. I would also encourage you to look if you see larger price patterns, one may see those divergences appear there as well. Now, if I was to go ahead and apply this indicator, let's double click on that. Go ahead and move this up to the top here a little bit. Move that out. There we go. All right, so if we go ahead and look at this on balance volume, maybe a little thin. Now you can always right click on the indicator, select edit study, and go ahead and make those lines a little bit thicker. So here we can see an example of on balance volume being applied to Apple. And as we see the price action making higher highs, higher lows. And as we look at this example of the on balance volume, notice it's making characteristically a similar higher high and higher low. However, one may keep an eye, at least over the near term, is if the on balance volume takes out some previous lows or previous highs, that can potentially show a bit of a divergence there. At the very least, be prepared to see a possible price pattern form, like a triangle or a rectangle. If there's continued selling, price may end up breaking below support, and you may see that on balance volume continue to fall. Let's see what else we got here. Now, that's just Apple here. Let's bring up a couple other examples. Now here's Valero. Valero talked a little bit about this possibly last week. Valero is kind of forming more of a possibly bottom formation, at least a triangle there. It was breaking down, kind of snapped back up, nose prices breaking out. We did see a surge of volume here prior to that gap there. And as we look at the on-balance volume, is the on-balance volume confirming that or not? Okay. Notice looking at the volume, and these indicators can lag, is still kind of showing more of a sideways pattern. Now, it's not going lower and making lower lows. It's actually kind of holding out. So notice here during the formation of this pattern, this on balance volume did have a slightly more bullish bias as it did go higher, pulled back, made an equal low, kind of consolidated and pushed higher. So, you know, so far, cumulatively, looks like the on balance volume has been supporting that price to the upside. We just haven't necessarily seen a surge or a follow through on that at the moment. Now, that's one way of visualizing and looking at on balance volume. Another way of looking at on balance volume is possibly utilizing, similar to what we've done in the past, is some averages or kind of almost like an oscillator to visualize this. That's where on balance volume modified comes into play here. And what it does is basically displays the on balance volume just a little bit differently, utilizing moving averages. And the crossover of these averages may signify potential more accumulation if it's a positive crossover, or possibly more distribution if there's a negative crossover. Now, with any indicator, it's all about different periods of time. The default setting for the on balance volume modified is a 7-10. It's a 7 average with a 10 period, I believe, on the signal line. I'm going to do a modification on that later, but we are going to stick with this example for right now. How does this look a little bit different? And what I'm going to do is, just so we get rid of some of the space here, I'm going to remove some of these indicators. We'll just focus on the volume here for a moment. And then let's, while we're doing that, we'll double check, see if we got any questions there. I know Lee's doing a great job of answering questions. Thank you, Lee. All right, I think we're in good hands there. Thanks, Lee. All right, so as you go ahead and look at, you know, something like Valero here, since we already have it on the screen, and come back, notice as you look at the developments of some trends, for instance, back here with Valero, when it broke out back in the summer of this past year, notice those moving average crossovers crossing above that 55, signifying a potential change in trend, as we highlighted last week. Notice that the volume was already supporting that. Here we see the on-balance volume as that initial indicator rising, and notice breaking out as the price breaks out. Now, the on-balance volume modify actually looks like it goes back a little further than that, and kind of coming off of those bottoms. Notice when the price was trending down, we see this on balance volume actually falling, being more negative. Now, there are some cases where the faster line kind of came up to that signal line, which is in red in this example. And, you know, some traders potentially anticipating, you know, a reversal. But notice, as far as price, that price is still down. We're still below a major average, in this case, a 55 period average, representing the intermediate trend. Haven't quite broken out of that, but traders may be keeping a sign to look for a pattern to form, such as a double bottom. And notice in this case, a double bottom was starting to form as price went ahead and tested those lows. However, notice looking at the on-balance volume, that on-balance volume was still falling, okay? So even though the price momentum slowed down, based off of volume, volume wasn't shifting. Really didn't start shifting until price started testing some of those averages. And then as it was consolidating, noticed the volume starting to build up from a positive standpoint, positive crossover of that on balance volume preceding the breakout and bullish reversal in the case of Valero. Now, if you go ahead and fast forward, at times you can see over the course of the trend in this example, you know, there have been some negative crossovers, but keep in mind, even though volume may precede price, volume is not necessarily the deciding factor. Price is what you're buying and selling and looking for that price to confirm. Even though there may have been some little negativity as far as that on-balance volume, notice the price action was still making higher highs and higher lows, even in the case of the on-balance volume still generally holding a little more of a bullish bias. It wasn't more decisively as you go back and look at the price action, a little more of a smaller rectangle. You have your trending indicator, in this case, 55 period moving average, looking for that support to hold if the trend was to continue from that intermediate period. As we go, we can see price breaking down, testing that average. Notice in some of these indicators, like the on-balance volume, taking out some of those previous lows, we see a negative crossover in this on-balance modified. And notice price continued to follow down. So the application here, as far as on-balance volume, if someone is in a trend trade, they may utilize that volume to look at price another way. And if they see that volume dropping off, and let's say you're near your price objectives or price targets, one may want to be a little more cautious or be prepared for that trend to potentially break down. If one's utilizing a stop order, for instance, they may look to raise that to preserve some of those gains. Keep in mind that stop orders are not guaranteed to fill or near that trigger price. They would compete with other income and market orders in the case of a stop market order. Okay. I'll see if anyone has any questions on that. And what we'll do is we'll talk about scanning for some of these instances here. And if you have any questions, feel free to share. So currently, as far as current state with Valero, as far as the crossover, it's kind of whipsawing there a little bit. But if price is breaking out, we do have a bit of volume right here. You know, some traders may look for an entry and potentially trade that. Now let's go ahead and see if we can go ahead and scan for these examples. I'm going to show you two ways. One is utilizing the scan tab on thinkorswim. Took the liberty to share these here. Now the on balance volume modified that we're looking at the chart, what this scan attempts to do is find stocks where there is whether a bullish or positive crossover or a negative crossover on that individual stock. Now, these examples are looking at the S&P 500. You're encouraged to modify these scans however way you wish, make them your own, keeping in mind that they are for illustrative and educational purposes and are not guaranteed for accuracy or time. Starting off with the bullish scan. I'm going to go ahead and show you how you can do that. You can transcribe that. I'll go ahead and put it in there in the chat. And be careful with the spaces there, but they're both in there. For those of you that are listening to the archive session, you can pause and transcribe them. We'll also have them in the description. All right, so we're going to go ahead and take that first one there. Go to the upper right-hand corner to the gear, select open shared item. Once there, we can plug that in. Then we'll go ahead and we'll click preview. If you typed it in right, it should show up like this. Now, since this is using technical indicators, folks, this will only work on a real-time platform. It will not work on the paper money. So you can do the scans on your real-time platform if you wish to practice trade. You can go ahead and do that on your paper money practice account there. Go ahead and type in code. You can name it whatever you'd like. This example was more of the on balance volume. Bullish. Again, call it whatever you'd like. Since I already have it, I'm not going to resave it here. And I'll go ahead and run the results. Again, this example is looking at the S&P 500. You know, once you go ahead and load the scan and make it your own, you can always come here and change and look at, you know, the entire market or any watch list, whether personal or public watch list that you'd like to find these results. We'll use the S&P 500 as an example. And upon scanning, it's showing that there are five stocks that meet this criteria today. Now, keep in mind, this is a little more of a real-time scan. It's dynamic. Things can change during the day, certainly from day to day, as far as with any potential signal. Not a recommendation to buy or sell. All it's telling us is that there was a positive crossover based off of that on-balanced volume we were looking at. So let's take a closer look. Keep in mind too, you can always, once you save that scan and you have it imported, you can always go right to the next of that little flame and save that scan, certainly if you make any changes to it. And that way, that'll be a dynamic list you can bring up on your watch lists. So if I go over here on the watch lists, that OBV bullish, there's the same stocks that were on the scan we were just looking at. Go to the chart. Let's take a look at Walmart. Now, what's interesting with Walmart, this actually ties up some of the principles that I talked with you on my first webcast upon return from military leave. We talked about Fibonacci retracements as far as support and resistance. We talked about moving averages in combination as far as identifying trends and potential reversals of trends. Now we're talking about on balance volume. And here, actually, everything we talked about over the last few weeks is applied just based off of that simple result on that scan. One, we go back and we look at the trend of Walmart going to the low in March of earlier this year to the high back in November, draw Fibonacci retracement. We talked about that 50% retracement. We talked about that 61.8 kind of potential make or break as far as the trend. Notice that price pretty much formed a dragonfly doji right in the area of that 61.8 level of resistance, okay? And price has came off a little bit. Now, price is still making lower highs and lower lows, but what traders may be keeping an eye on is looking for a breakout, you know, above a previous high. As we talked about moving average crossovers, possibly looking for more of a positive crossover. When we see this happen over the shorter term, that could potentially be the first sign of potentially an intermediate reversal and looking for the follow through if prices are able to reclaim those highs and see the intermediate trend reverse more towards the upside. Very active traders may be looking a little counter trend to possibly trade up into those resistance areas. As we look at the on balance volume, notice the on balance volume had been falling, you know, over the shorter term. We're seeing a little more of a higher high there. You know, is this volume preceding price? This is kind of one of the first ideas. If one's looking for a bullish reversal, what does volume have to say about it? And then have it on your watch list and continue to follow it to see if price is able to follow through and break out. Notice on the on balance volume modified, here we have a positive crossover. So this will be kind of something to keep an eye on in the coming days or weeks and see if price is able to confirm that potential breakout. Let's see what else we got on the other examples. We have Meta. Now, Meta is already in an existing uptrend and looks like breaking out to new 52-week highs. I'm not sure if that's all-time highs. Not quite all-time highs, but 52-week highs. You know, as we look at the on-balance volume, notice that that volume had dropped with that last pullback. And interestingly, notice that the volume hasn't picked up for new highs. So we are potentially seeing a negative divergence on Meta, that even though price has made higher highs, we're not necessarily seeing that in the on-balance volume. That doesn't mean that Meta is going to reverse and form a bearish trend, but there is a bit of a sign that as prices approach those highs, maybe it's going back to those multi-year highs, that momentum may slow down, volume may precede that by dropping off, and then looking to see if that confirms by price dropping as well. But at least over the shorter term, we're seeing another positive crossover that volume is supporting that breakout, okay? There is a chat in there from Speak Truth when we're looking at the patterns here. Walmart. Good observation. You know, can you see patterns in studies? And the question answer to that is yes. So for instance, I think you're making reference here on potential of an inverse head and shoulders being displayed on the on balance volume, which may confirm or precede what we may see as a potential inverse head and shoulders on the price as well. So good eye on that. Appreciate the feedback. Let's look at one other one here. And I want to go over some of the script here. Oracle was another one. Okay, so here's Oracle. Let's back this out a little more. Now, Oracle's kind of gone back and forth. Notice as far as price basically came down and tested a low. And basically bounced off of that low. You can see a bit of volume here back and forth as price consolidated at that low. Now, as we look at on balance volume, it's kind of gone back and forth. We're not necessarily seeing a trend upwards on balance volume, but we're also not necessarily seeing a trend downward. This came up on the list because there was a positive crossover occurring today. However, sometimes take that for previous observations as well. This stock has had a couple of whipsaws as far as that volume. So an idea here may be looking for the on-balance volume to break higher to be supported by price. Otherwise, this is just an example of a bullish bounce coming off of that resistance. And some traders may look to anticipate that and possibly make an entry on that. In our example here, if we wanted to do a sample trade, let's go ahead and do that. I'm gonna right click and I'm just gonna do, I'm gonna go ahead and do a buy custom with stop. What we'll do is we'll just go ahead and put the stop a percentage below that low, let's say 3%, that's at around 99. I'm just going to go ahead and put, let's say 96 as an example. We're going to make that stop GTC for good till cancel. We'll uncheck that there, make sure we got the current price. We're going to do 100 shares for this example here. If one's position size and based off the size of your account, on a practice account, consider that. Notice in this case, this is a $100,000 sample account. This about 10% of the equity of the account tied up in this one stock. Theoretically, if we were to be stopped out of the price, we're looking at about $10 risk per share on 100. That would be $1,000. That's about 1% of this account. Now it's assuming, keep in mind, stops are not guaranteed to fill at an exact execution price. That execution price will be equal to, or it's no guarantee it'll be equal to or near that activation price.
It'll be more where the market is at that time. And those markets can move pretty quick. So I'm gonna go ahead and send this through as an example. And we'll follow through to see, you know, is this anticipating that volume is gonna participate? Is a little too early? Some traders may utilize this as a way to leg in to a position or scale into a position, I should say, when they see signs off support and then look to follow through as the price breaks up and possibly forms higher highs as well as higher lows. All right, so we showed you on how to scan for that. The other thing I wanted to share with you, likewise on the bearish side, so you can see what that looks like. If I go ahead and bring up the bearish one. Now, there's actually a few more stocks appearing on this one based off of that. Let's say, interesting. Let's look at Coca-Cola. Okay, so here's Coca-Cola. You know, as many stocks, you had the melt up in October going into November there. And, you know, are there signs that things may be cooling off? You see an engulfing pattern on price. You see a little more volatility here, surge in volume, more of a hammering pattern, going a little back and forth. Notice the on-balance volume did break down here. Again, it's not the sole indicator, and we're seeing a negative crossover. So, you know, investors who may have been in that trend may be keeping an eye to see if that trend breaks down. If the price continues to rise, volume should follow it. You can see in other cases, I think like here's Munster. Notice price going sideways, the indicator going sideways. And when things are going sideways, moving averages are going to have a tendency of having whipsaws. So even though we have a negative crossover, cumulatively, it's just been going back and forth. So we can utilize moving averages the same way for this indicator as we may utilize on price. Wait for the breakout. Okay. The last thing I wanted to share with you is a column script. Now, make note, I'll go ahead and I'll put this in the chat as well. There's two examples here. I've been having a little issues on some of the cross-platform things, so I just want to make sure that cover our bases there. The first one on the screen, if you're on the thinkorswim blue, that should cover you. If you're on the legacy platform, that second code should cover you, or whatever. If the first one doesn't work, try the second one or vice versa. It should be applicable to you. Okay. Now, what this quote column script is doing, have it listed here. Notice that I have a series of positive and you may see some negatives. Now, I made a modification on this one. Instead of using the default 710, what I did, and I'll show you how to visualize this, I'm going to right click. And I want you to take a look at this, see if this changes here. I'm going to right click, edit, and I'm utilizing a sample Fibonacci series 13 and 21. So what I'm doing here is I'm pushing the observations out further. So for a trend trade, trend traders are trying to avoid whipsaws, trying to find a pattern or a period that would give them reasonable signals, but also try to minimize the whipsaws. This is an intention of doing that. Now, we can still use the faster signal on the scan to anticipate possible moves in price. But as far as an existing trend, this may be a way of smoothing out that period. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna apply that, click OK. And notice in this example on Munster, notice how that kind of smoothed out the whipsaws we were seeing on the faster indicator. So if someone was in a trend on this example, based off of volume, they may look to maintain that position since that volume hasn't had a negative crossover. Likewise, if we look at some of the examples we were looking at from a positive standpoint, such as Walmart, notice that it has not crossed over as of yet. because it's a slower signal. So if one's looking at it more over a longer duration, they may look to that period. But more than likely, if you see the confluence, if this ends up being a bullish reversal and breaks above the moving average, we're more likely to see that volume potentially confirm that, okay? As notice the OPV is rising. If price is rising, OPV is rising, then a crossover potentially would happen, okay? Now to add that one, all you need to do is go ahead, same thing, go up to the gear in the upper right-hand corner, go ahead and select that example. That is a exclamation point on that first one, if that's the one that works for you. You go to open shared item, go ahead and plug in that information. Again, it's case sensitive. You click preview and name it whatever you'd like. It may already pop up OBV. You can call it OBV, OBV mod, whatever helps you remember that. Once that's imported, and I already have it in there, then it should be part of your custom quote column. So when you go to a watch list, you can simply right click on any column, select customize, and look for the one that you saved. There's the OBV. You can double click and go ahead and add it. So notice here, folks, what we've done, and I'm just going to go back. I'll just bring up the S&P 500. So what we've done over the last couple of weeks is we've tied in trend, support and resistance, and volume. And as far as our productivity tools here, and we're combining them, and we will continue to combine them in the coming weeks going into the new year as we'll integrate relative strength. I have an example of trending indicators with the moving average crossovers. We can see in green as examples of trends that are potentially strong. With the on-balance volume modified, smoothed out a little bit, we can also see if at least currently volume is supporting price. So when you go ahead and look at some of these examples, okay, there's American Airlines. You know, we talked about these inverse head and shoulders on some of these airlines. Notice volume preceding that breakout, positive crossover preceding that breakout. Nice example of volume preceding price. And as price is rising, we're seeing the volume continue to support that. And a trend trader may keep an eye on that until it doesn't. And that may start with a breakdown, lower lows, and seeing the volume breakdown as well. And depending on the period of time, these indicators may show that potential change. In the case of PCG, okay, things are going a bit more sideways. We have a rectangle. Volume falling, negative crossovers. Again, the trend has not changed. It's still above the average. But if one was in a trend trade, they may be preparing for an exit if the price breaks that support, because that potentially can be negative volume preceding a negative breakdown in price. Okay. So, folks, I would encourage you to practice what you learned here today. Possibly go back and look at the playlist for these sessions as well, as we tie in the principles of technical analysis to actually applying them on the charts, utilizing some indicators that can be fairly simple to use. Moving averages, and in this case, on balance volume to help support that potential trend. We went through a few examples with you. I would encourage you to do on your own. Maybe look at some stocks in your portfolio as well as individual stocks. I'd like to thank Mr. Lee Bull for being with us on the chat today and helping everything out. I wish all of you to have, if we don't see you during the rest of the week, to have a safe and prosperous holiday season, and looking forward to seeing you in the new year. Take care, everyone. Follow us on Twitter. And if you loved what you learned here today, go ahead and click like. Have a great day, everyone.